wishing you were a banner strand, holding your nephew's hands. We walked along the waterfront, up Bunker, down on Main. We met at the monument, where everyone knew our names. Our first kiss on 40 flights, our friends on the stoop on summer nights. The church door was always open as the bells rang out for you and me, for all to see on our wedding day. There's an immigrant soul under.
Good evening. Welcome to Charlestown Live. I'm Billy Boyle, your host for the evening program. First, before we begin, I'd like to thank our partner, Chad, Charleston Against Drugs, and our sponsors, the Partners Healthcare, including the MGH Institute of Health Professionals, the Spalding Rehab at the Navy Yard, and the MGH SHOP program. Without these people, we couldn't bring you this program. This is a tape show, so we will not have any live call-ins. The two gentlemen I have on tonight have busy schedules, so it's tough to get them together on a Thursday night. So we decided if we could tape the show early, we could have the two of them together instead of separate. And it's quite the thing to have the two gentlemen I get on, because the business they're in, usually people, they're mortal enemies, but these two guys are great friends and they're great townies, and I've known them for a long time. So first of all, I'll introduce the younger of the two, Dennis Taylor. Dennis, thanks for coming tonight,
pal. Thank you, Mr. B.
And I'll have the older gentleman, a couple years older.
Watch your mouth.
Michael Smokey Cain. Smokey,
hello,
nice to
William.
Have you, pal.
Good to see you.
It's nice to have you guys together. I know you're good friends. Mm-hmm. And the business you're in, it's a tough business because you work weekends, work days, you have funerals, you do functions. But I want to get a little something. Who wants to start? I don't care. But first of all, I think we'd like to mention, on behalf of Charleston, I want to thank the Boston Police Department and the departments that are involved for the, they made an arrest in the Ryan Dookie Morrissey shooting. And I know Dennis was a very close friend of Dookie, so if you want to say a couple words, Dennis?
Yeah, it's a tragedy. I mean, the whole town has felt the pain of the loss. Our close friends, it's been a roller coaster of emotions the last couple months, but we can finally start to get on our way towards some closure after today's arrest. And, it's going to still be a long process and a long healing process, but we know that he's always watching over us, and we love him. So, Deuce, we love you. Keep watching over us, and, we're just going to have to keep going and keep carrying on. Make him proud.
Yeah, I thought it would be best if we mentioned. I know when we had the we did the show in middle of November, just before Thanksgiving, after the tragedy happened. We had a moment of silence the night of Charlestown Live. Mm-hmm. But like I said, it's we don't like to do negatives, but it's a positive.
Absolutely.
So I want to thank everybody involved, and like Dennis said, we'll move on. Let the process handle itself.
Yep.
All right, with that, I think we'll have a, give us a little something about yourself, Dennis, when you started, how long you've been doing it.
Well, I'm an entertainer, a singer, DJ. Music is my life. Many people know that. Without it, I would not be who I am. I got started just listening to the music that my grandmother and my mother played around the house, the old Motown and disco, Philly soul stuff, and I just fell in love with it. And so now I'm starting to make it a career, and I got my first, I'll give a plug, my first gig was in Charlestown at the Zelma Lacey House, and Mr. Boyle's wife is the one that got me that gig, Dodie. Thank you, Dodie. now it's just, it's crazy. I'm working with a great producer in Philadelphia by the name of Bobby Eli, who wrote a lot of songs for groups like Blue Magic and Teddy Pendergrass and all the old school soul singers from the 70s. And I'm actually proud to announce I'll have my first single out in the next couple months. It'll be on iTunes. And so it's still surreal that I'm able to make my passion and love a career, and it's like, it's just amazing.
And you're at the old age of what now?
19. Yeah.
All right, now we're going to ask a little something about Smokey. What about you, pal? You've been on it for a little longer than Dennis.
Almost as long as Dennis has been on the planet. And in my case, some of your viewers may remember a guy by the name of Disco Vinnie Peruzzi. It all began then. We were good friends, and I borrowed a lot of his music. I may have boosted a few along the way, off of him, you know, a lot of his CDs. And back then, I'm guessing it was cassettes or whatever. And
45s.
Yeah, maybe. 8 tracks or whatever. I mean, he had a vault downstairs of, you couldn't begin to imagine the music he had. At the time, I was in the Roofers Union. I was involved with Charlestown Papuana, you know, and a few other organizations back then. And my brother Kevin, who I have to start by saying, has been my hero through all of this. This is where it began. I owe everything to my brother Kevin. Kevin used to take my mother's stereo system and do parties with it, you know? And this was just a little portable stereo system, and he loved it. And I'll never forget the day that he just received his master's from Boston University. We watched him walk out of there with his cap and gown on Calm Ave. First thing he wanted to do was stop into a guitar center, you know, and look at systems. And to me, I always saw the glasses half empty when Kevin brought this up, and he wanted to go into business and try this out. And fast forward, 16, 17 years? What a journey it's been, Billy.
Yeah, you two guys, I know you do a lot of work in the town, and I know you both work out of the town.
Yep.
I think you both travel a lot, but Dennis, you travel a little few more miles than Smokey does,
couple
I think.
Couple miles, yeah.
Yeah, you're down in Atlantic City or something?
Yeah, I'm doing some, I did a show in Atlantic City about, going probably about, almost 2 years ago, about a year and a half. The National R&B Music Society invited me on their summer concert series down on the basin down there by the aquarium, and they had me on there, and they invited me back to be perform at their award ceremonies that they throw to honor classic soul and R&B singers. And now I was booked on a gig next month, April 25th. I'll be performing in Wildwood, New Jersey. With Tavares and Carol Douglas, Carol Williams, all the R&B disco legends that we all love to listen to. And I'm doing a lot of work in Philly still. I work with, like I mentioned before, I work with a producer down there, and we're working on my debut CD now. And yeah, so I mean, definitely that tri-state area, I'm doing a lot of work down there.
Well, you're out of town. We got Smokey doing all the in-town, in-house stuff. But
I'll switch up with him.
I know.
I'm happy.
But I tell you, I know the 2 years, like I mentioned, you do a lot of work with the nonprofits. And we're really thrilled. The time that these two gentlemen put in, I know for Chad, for CSAC, you know, just the Zelma Lacey House, Harvest on Vine, whatever is up, you guys are doing it, and the out-the-park jobs during the summer. And very very seldom do we ever get shot down by you guys. Yeah. What time? I don't know. I only do a couple hours. An hour is, you know. But everybody's thrilled, and they're happy what you do. But it's got to take a lot of time on you, because you do gigs on the weekend, and you get gigs in the middle of the weeks, too, funerals, after funerals, which is... You know, you hate to say, but, you know, some people do have music. But I notice I've been in a lot of times with both of you. Do you really have much time on the weekends? All your weekends are tied up, both of you, really.
Yeah.
And, I mean, you both work during the weekdays.
Right.
So where the heck do you get and you lug everything. Well, I know you get a lot of help. I see you here huffing and puffing down there sometimes up the park there, pal.
Right.
You know, like I say, I like to thank you on behalf of the nonprofits. we would like to thank you, you know. I think you guys do a great job. I think Dennis has a little one more thing going than you do, Mike. He does a lot of singing. Mm-hmm. You don't do your singing, pal.
You don't want to hear my singing. Yeah. You know.
But you really get into that singing when you with your music.
Yeah.
That's not part of your, when you do a gig, unless people request
exactly.
it.
Exactly, yeah.
And I know sometimes it can be very, it could be a nuisance too, because they'd rather have you sing all night instead
right.
of play the music.
Right,
yeah. Yeah, so I know, your brother has been, how's your brother doing anyway, Mike?
Both of them, actually, Billy.
One had the surgery.
I had one the day after his 50th birthday, pulmonary embolisms, which led to a major stroke, paralyzed left side.
Yeah.
He's been down Spalding, and we're hoping to have him on his feet soon. And my brother, my colleague, my right-hand man, Kevin, he's in the middle of chemo, so he's been wiped out, and of course, I have to take on his workload.
Yeah.
I don't mind, because you talk about it, like all the work that's involved and the time on our weekends. Billy, we're getting paid to party.
Okay?
And when you have as much towny pride as we do.
Well, that's it.
It's a gift.
Yeah, I do have to say it. I mean, everybody brags about you in the town. And they brag about you out of town, the gigs that you do out of town, too. It's nice they have a couple of gentlemen from the town. Is there anything coming up for you that's...
There's a lot. There's you mentioned Harvest on
Harvest
the Vine.
Harvest on the Vine,
that's April 15th.
April 15th.
Yeah.
Dennis is going to be singing.
I'll be there as well.
He's going to do a little tribute.
Yeah. The family of Ryan Morrissey asked me
to
come and do a song in his memory. So all of our friends will be there paying tribute to him that night. They're going to do a little something special for him. His family will be in attendance, and it'll be a nice gesture and tribute
good.
To Ryan.
Good. Yeah. Very nice, yep. Yeah. And I know that, like I said, I grew up with your family. And Mikey, I grew up with your family, your mom and dad. I knew the two of them. Went to school with your dad. I had to tell a little
I'm
story
sorry to
here.
Hear that.
I knew he was gonna. I was going to say it to him. Your father and I ran for class president.
And
Charlestown High.
I'm surprised you brought that up because, you were first runner-up.
No, I just edged him out. His nickname was Hoagie.
Right, Hoagie and Smokey.
And some of these people, they don't really know who I'm talking about because, all they know is Smokey Cain, Kevin Cain, and your brothers.
Right.
But your dad's been gone a long time,
mm-hmm.
and your mom has been gone a long time. But I grew up with them, and like I said, I went to school with your dad. And then I grew up with all the Buckley family for years.
Yep.
We used to live almost in the same building.
Yep.
So like I said, you want to say anything about your family? Oh, you got the little niece that loves the heck out of you, I guess.
Oh, yeah. My cousin.
Carly. Yeah.
Yeah, she's the best. I got her into some of the new, my music. Now, I got to pass it on to somebody.
Yeah.
It's almost, that's one thing about Charlestown is the music that we're into, that old school R&B stuff. There's not a square mile that I know of that has that much rhythm and right. appreciation for that kind of music. I got to mention a couple other DJs. Eddie Barnett, Eddie B.
Mm-hmm.
And Kevin McGough and all those guys those are who I learned the music from them. I go up Eddie's house almost every other night and we listen to records and I go over Kevin's house all the time and we listen to records and it's like a tradition in Charlestown for DJs, good DJs and good entertainers to come out of Charlestown. So we gotta keep it going. So I've tried to get her into it a little bit so she can pass the torch, maybe.
Is it true Eddie B still has his old 45s and
78s? Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
You still have some of those, Mike, don't you? No?
Are you picking on my age again,
no.
Billy? Is that what you're pointing out?
I think Dennis still has
some.
Dennis,
I collect them, yep. Yeah.
And did you ever get one of those phonographs to play them?
Yeah.
Oh, you do play those?
I got LPs, 45s.
33 and a third.
I got them all. They're just something about the preservation of keeping that I don't know what the word I'm looking for. That style and that way of listening to music alive, because You know, I just actually read an article the other day. This last year has been the biggest selling year in vinyl records since like the late 80s. And so it's starting to come back a little bit. So
and the phonographs are coming back. I heard, what is it? Some of the stores are selling the old phonographs again. So they can. So you have to use the vinyl again.
Absolutely.
I got some old records, 33 and a thirds, and the old Four Seasons back in the 60s
Frankie
and
Valley.
70s.
Yeah.
They're in a case, and I have never touched them, so I don't even know if they work.
Wow.
But they're still in the original folders and everything. You know, my kids get a kick out of it. What's that? You know, you pick it out, it's this big black disc. What's that? I said, it's a record. Well, how do you play it? I said, you put on a phonograph. What's a phonograph?
Right.
I mean, it's unbelievable.
And no one would understand like B-side. I mean, my very B-sides. First 45 was ABC by the Jackson 5. Yep. And, you know, flip sides of those records.
Flip sides are always the hidden gems.
Right. Well, and a lot of them, a lot of big hits come out of the side B.
Yep.
Like you say, everybody played side A. And they never paid, and all of a sudden the B side come out. Yeah. Ooh, I have that. I have both of them.
Yeah, why didn't I flip that over before?
Yeah. He actually knows a little bit about music at all the events that I go to.
Absolutely. I did a time
up at my son's house.
Yep. Yeah. And we were sitting out on the deck and I was playing music and he would come over. Oh, you play this is by, you know, so-and-so group from 1955. He knows the years and everything.
Yeah,
another music man.
You're going way back,
right,
55, pal.
Big bands, maybe.
We played Earth Angel, that's 55.
Yeah. I could go back a few more.
More like the Chattanooga Choo Choo or something, 1930s music. But
that was
1912 Overture.
We used both get a lot of requests for the old 60s.
Oh,
I know it's at the functions we go to. I go to a lot of the functions and people love that 60s music. Yeah. I guess it's like you say, it's still nostalgia.
Exactly.
Billy, I can tell you this. At every event that Dennis and I do, my brother and them, it's pretty much a no-brainer.
Mm-hmm.
Dennis mentioned Charlestown. I mean, I can close my eyes and...
You know what they're going to ask for right away.
Of course. And I can look out at the crowd and I can attach a song to every person in that crowd.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Right.
Well, everybody has their own little favorite song, and then they have their favorite group. I mean, I notice when you go and you guys are up there and you say any requests, and people run up and they sign it. And it's a lot of times you get a lot, and sometimes you don't get any.
Right.
But I got it's easy because you guys know how to play to the crowd.
Right.
The age bracket is the big thing.
Right.
If it's an older crowd, you know they're going to want the 60s and 70s. You got the young kids now; it's all that R&B and we got the new music.
Yeah. So that's what you call
you don't, see,
music.
He doesn't even know what it's called. It's
hip-hop,
Billy.
Hip-hop. I don't know. You just call it R&B, hip-hop, rap, and it's all one thing. I have no idea. Just give me the oldies but goodies, you know?
Yeah, he wants At the Hop or whatever.
Yeah,
I know
Danny
Billy
and the Juniors.
Yeah. There you go. Very good.
Billy. Yeah. I said we were, when Dennis was up at my son's house, it was funny. He was on the deck playing, and I went out and I sat with him, and he was playing all the oldies, and it was fun. You know, we were going through it, and people were hollering up, keep playing that music, keep playing that. Well, there was no one dancing anyway down the yard.
And what's more amazing than that, Billy, is he's not only actually plays the music, he's performed with half of the people he's playing these days. I mean, I'm awestruck even just to be in the same circle with you guys.
Yeah, we used to do a lot of work together, though.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I've seen us both in the same hall at the same time. I mean, it's amazing. Like you said, it's a competitive business, and you figure, I'm going to beat him out. I want to get those jobs. But I guess it just doesn't make any difference because you're both in demand.
Absolutely.
And we used to have Dennis Moore.
Yeah.
Franny Weimert was a DJ back in the 50s, I think. I don't know if you guys ever remember him. He's still alive. He lives on Main Street. But he was around. He was playing the same time Eddie B was.
Okay.
And Eddie B was good.
Yeah.
And he still has all those old records. I know
he has
them
all. I'm up there, like I said, almost every other night. We go through his 45s and everything. And he it's amazing. He still has a rotary phone, too. He does.
So does it actually.
I was going to say, you've been looking through my window, pal. Anything going on with your families or anything coming up with you guys in the town outside? You know, a couple of gigs, but what's going on with your families?
I got You know, we just, I'd like to just give a shout out to my great grandmother, right, who I call Gigi. You know, she's not feeling too great lately,
right,
but
that's what I heard. Yeah.
So she, I just want to give her a shout out. She'll be watching when this airs, so yeah. I want to make sure I say I love you, Gigi, and I'm thank you for watching, and I just love you to the moon and back.
No, it's good.
Smart man. Upcoming events, Billy. I have CSAC, Shannon Lindeen, hello. Yeah. Promise to give you a plug. Another angel. She's been on here a bunch.
Yeah,
couldn't compete with her. We have the Turn It Around event this weekend for the kids.
Oh, you that's know, right.
Trying to keep up.
Basketball.
Yes, yes. It's being held in the Y, at the Y, Charlestown Y.
And the Boys Club.
Yes. Friday is at the YMCA.
Right.
And then Saturday at the Charlestown Boys and
Girls Club. I'm glad I brought that up because I did. I talked to Sarah Coughlin yesterday and I told her I'd mention it. I'm glad I brought it up because I would have forgot it.
Right.
I didn't write it down.
This weekend's event. See? Well, there you go, Billy. You're welcome.
No script.
Yeah. Right.
Because I know, because if you look at a script, you forget where you are and then you forget it anyway. No, they do. You're right. They got the Boys Club and the Y.
Right.
They're splitting it up, right.
And we can identify. That's the best way to go with no script. I'll never forget my first event. Dennis actually, so, you know, when he first began, we have this conversation all the time. And Billy, like I said, this pales in comparison to the ride over here. I mean, put two musical lovers together. And I just remember doing this event and, you know, I'm talking to my brother at the time and I had this great thing to say, you know, to finish the night with. It was going to go out with a bang and it was going to be perfect. He hands me the microphone. I choked on it, you know, so I can identify with, you know, scripting before you do anything. But, you know, as for Dennis, what an amazing, amazing young gentleman. And what's even more than that, Billy, is like I said, I'm sure I'm not alone. When something as simple as seeing the Bunker Hill Monument brightens my day, okay? You know, you mentioned Deucey, little Deucey.
Yeah.
You know, a bunch of us have gotten together and we've started the Gift of Love Foundation, Stephen Jones murder.
Yeah.
Remember that? And we have a lot coming up with that. In May, we're going to have an event. And you know, through tragedy comes triumph. It, you know, there's a lot of... The unity that's involved is amazing, Billy, and I think that's the biggest gift, I'm sure Dennis can attest to, is the biggest gift that we received is just being a part of, you know, the town we love so much.
Well, you know, I make this statement a lot on the show. I'm very proud of Charlestown. And like I said, if you cut half the people in Charlestown, they bleed townie blood.
Yep.
I think it's like that in most towns, but... We're so small and unique. We got the 2-minute warning 2 minutes ago. So we're almost out of time, guys. So anything you'd like to wrap it up with?
Just I have a couple performances coming up. Actually, well, tonight, I guess. This is airing on Thursday. I'll be up Polcari's on Route 1 in Woburn starting at 8:30. So after you watch the show, come on up.
Yeah.
And at the end of the month, on the 28th, I'll be at Polcari's in Woburn. So I have a couple of events. And my website is... www.dennistmusic.com. I have upcoming events on there and things like that. So if you'd like to come out and check a show, I'd love to see you.
Very good. And Mike, you get up the turnaround this weekend.
That's what I have. But if you haven't seen Dennis, he's absolutely incredible. I can, you know, love him to death.
I told you this show will go fast, folks. So this show is going to be aired Thursday night. Two gentlemen were busy tomorrow night, so... I have to say, I want to thank the two of them immensely for coming on. It was tough to get them here at the same time. They are busy guys. But I want to thank Dennis.
Thank you, Mr. Dagger. Boyle.
I want to thank Smokey. Thanks,
all right,
Smokey.
Billy Boy.
And I want to thank the people of Charlestown for watching. And remember, Charlestown, respect one another. God bless Charlestown, and good night.
Amen.
And remember Charlestown, now and forever. God bless Charlestown. Good night.